In 1943, Karl Oberteufer's picture was hung in the Falmouth Post Office, but not for the reasons you might think. This picture wasn't a photograph on an FBI poster. It was a mural commissioned by a New Deal program similar to the WPA that put artists like Oberteufer to work, decorating post offices across the country. Karl was born in Le Croisic in Brittany in 1908. His French mother, Henriette, and his American father, George, were both artists. Though the family, which included Karl's sister Betty, found time to visit the countryside, they mainly lived in Paris, where George's work was well respected. George's circle included other expatriates, such as the African-American painter Henry Osawa Tanner. George was probably acquainted with John Singer Sargent as well. They both served in committees for the Panama Pacific Exposition of 1915. When war broke out in 1914, George went to the U.S. consulate and registered himself, his wife, and children as American citizens. He volunteered as a captain in the American Red Cross. Young Karl must have been aware of the terrible struggle, especially when the front line advanced to within 50 miles of Paris. After the armistice, the Oberteufers decided to move to the U.S. 11-year-old Karl, in his passport application, solemnly swore that even though he had never resided in the United States, he was a native and loyal citizen nevertheless. Once back home, George taught at many schools, including the Art Institute of Chicago, before he died in Gloucester in 1940, aged 62. Karl, meanwhile, married a Hingham native, gave art lessons in Boston, and began to build a reputation as a watercolorist. He produced his first post office mural in McKenzie, Tennessee, in 1938. His mother, Henriette, got in on the fun and painted a mural for Vicksburg, Mississippi. In the spring of 1942, Karl won the commission to decorate Falmouth's brand new post office. When he researched the town's history for a subject, his imagination was caught by the story of Joseph Dimmock's dawn raid at Tarpaulin Cove, where the militia recaptured a corn shipment from the British. Karl secured a studio at the McVitie Garage on Mill Road and moved in with his wife. Karl finished his work in October of 1942. Federal approval of the picture arrived 2 months later. But heavy rains in early December had leaked into the barely two-year-old post office, requiring repairs and more back-and-forth dealings with Washington. The mural was finally hung on August 21, 1943. By then, Karl had gone back to the Boston area. For the rest of his too short life, he continued to paint, to collect awards, and to teach. He also did optical research for RCA's Airborne Systems Laboratory. Karl died in 1958 in Boston, aged 49. More than 70 years have passed, and Karl's post office panorama is arguably the most widely viewed work of public art in town. Though its subject is a Revolutionary War hero, its hopeful message resonated with the World War II generation for whom it was created. Today, it reminds us of the many generations that have struggled for freedom. Karl told the Enterprise, "This is Falmouth's mural, and I want the town to be pleased." He delivered on that promise.